Hi, I'm Kono Tanku Fishu Niwa Yumegaru. Welcome to your bizarre adventure where people punch the shit out of each other with imaginary friends and do gay poses. This game takes place in an alternate universe where Made in Heaven f***ed up the universal reset and turned everyone into funny logo men with bootleg Jojo names such as Bonjourno Brovana, Jojo Mama, and Cars.
Look how they massacred my boys.
Actually, Made in Heaven probably sticked a narrow up his ass and got a third requiem, became Made in f***ing Hell and shat itself. It merged all the universes into one big cucked mess where you get to see sh** like Dio whipping his son, then getting killed by Hanke Niju Metodo, Emerado Splashio, or Fugo actually getting screen times. Like, what the f***? I am kind of obligated to give your bizarre adventure a 10 out of 10 because no matter how scuffed this game is, because of the infinite Diavolo death loop, this can technically be considered canon. Although I'm quite disappointed that there's not a fighting style that involves German science, because it would have been very fun to shoot people with machine gun in my gut and to scream obnoxiously. Stents are those menacing humanoid, possibly homosexual beings that stand next to you when you want to beat someone to death. That's why they're called stents, because they stand next to you. No, I'm actually serious, that's why they're called stents. But we all see the problem here, like, you know, some stents don't stand because they're objects. Huh? What the f***, Araki? Anyway, you get stents by stabbing yourself with arrows you find in the middles of nowhere. Be warned though, stabbing yourself with these arrows has a side effect of making you a little bit gay, schizophrenic, and possibly give you some random diseases like HIV. Unlike the anime, the arrow just snaps itself out of existence after you stab yourself with it. There's also an infinite supply of it, probably because God thought it was a good idea to solve overpopulation by making everyone gay. Oh yeah, you can also get stents by merging with Jesus' ribcage, and there's a lot of it. There's a lot of Jesus. How many bones does this man have? Of course, not everyone can get a stent. Only cool kids who have committed mass homicide are considered worthy enough to get one. If your stent is a disappointment, you can eat this red fruit that you also found in the middles of nowhere to get rid of it. Now, because you find it in random alleyways, rooftops, or in a ditch somewhere, this fruit will almost always give you severe diarrhea and you won't be able to stand straight for 3 days after eating it. Anyway, the skills of the stents in this game fall into these few categories. Category 1, beating the sh** out of the other guy. Category 2, anime teleport and omaiwa mushinderu. Category 3, moving so fast you can't see. Category 4, healing is kimochi. Category 5, f***ing around with time. Category 6, shooting stuff. Category 7, nigurundayu to another dimension. Category 8, making everyone fat. Category 9, dismemberment. Category 10, remote control. Category 11, let the bot do the job. Category 12, traps. Category 13, buffs and debuffs. Category 14, why are there so many categories? Oh, you know what? Category 14, everything else. It. Bye. Some stents can evolve into a steroid version of themselves. Gordo Experience, Kingu Crimson, Silva Chariato, Kira Queen, and Star Platina can evolve into the Requiem form. If you British yourself a second time with a Requiem arrow while saying, Kodega, Requiem. Duh. After getting Requiem, Goldo Experience gets a bunch of Uno reverse cards and will start giving not-so-gold experience to anyone attacking it. Kingu Crimson becomes an edgy teen. Silva Chariot loses its white privilege, said f*** it, and just became an entirely different stand. With its newly earned end pass, it obtains the overpowered ability called Conqueror's Will. Like, seriously, what the f***? Nerf it, man. Kira Queen can now use his Daisan no Bakudan and start biting Zadusto. And Star Platina becomes Sus Imposter and pretend to be Zavardo. You get Zavardo over heaven by reading Dio's diary.
Ore wa yowatteita. Kubi dake datta kara na. Moshi Jonathan Joestar no nikutai wo ubawanakatta na.
And completing the diary quest, Zavardo over heaven sold its Roda Rola in exchange for the ability to overwrite reality. You get Sea Moon by giving the gay priest Dio's diary and complete his quest and letting Whitesnake merge with baby Yoda. Tusk is a f***ing Pokemon and to evolve it you need Jesus. To get D4C Love Train you also need Jesus, his heart specifically. Finally, to get Made in Heaven you need to get Dio's boner, I mean bone, I mean f***. And Jojo Gun's Dolphin Porn Collection. What? Isn't that what's in the disc? Made in Heaven is annoying and fast as f. It can make an arena match last forever. Some people just straight up leave if you have this then, cause they don't wanna deal with this bullshit. You also get the ability to reset the universe and make everyone crippled. Before the update, Universal Reset also gives people crippling obesity. But now Made in Heaven stole Silver Chariot Requiem's ability and swaps everyone's bodies. If you want to be a huge asshole, spam this. Apart from stundos, you can also learn different fighting styles by paying and bringing items to these random people who are possibly homeless. Fighting styles are used to extend combos or to complement stands for that extra bit of damage. First, you have boxing, where you can auto the shit out of your enemies, knock them away with the big boy punch, or poke their f***ing eyes out. You can only use your boxing abilities when you have your gloves equipped, because the devs like to cock people. Like, seriously, why is it not in the toolbars? Why do I keep forgetting to drag it from my inventory to my toolbar? I have to open my inventory to get it in the middle of a fight. Why? Next, there's Hamon. He's photosynthesis to charge up solar energy and unleash the power of vitamin D on your enemies. Charge up your Hamon bar and get power equivalent to that of eating a whole jar of Flintstone gummies. You got a zoom punch that extends your reach, just like zoom call that extends your If zoom punch doesn't work,
sunlight or yellow overdrive.
If sunlight or yellow overdrive doesn't work,
scarlet or overdrive.
If scarlet or overdrive doesn't work, then you should use Nigerandayo. You know, I'm quite disappointed that you can't use the ultimate Hamon ability, aka
Sandokurasu split attack.
Spin is similar to Hamon. You can charge up your bar to do more damage. You can then punch with spin, throw your big balls of steel to your enemy, and harden your skin to literally have balls of steel. Use a stone mask to reject your humanity and become a vampire. Once you become a vampire, you can't go play outside during the day because
the sun is a deadly laser.
You become allergic to vitamin D and take more damage from Hamon. You can block sunlight with an umbrella, but you can't use your fist while holding it for obvious reasons. After becoming a vampire, you'll need to talk to the elder vampire to unlock vampirism so you can fire lasers out of your eyes, freeze people with your stinky breath, and drain other people's life because you don't have one. Filling up the blood bar gives you regen and speed buffs, and you can do it by sucking or buying it at the vampire bar. Just be careful of whose blood you're drinking because you might get hepatitis or HIV. If you want to take a sun bath or if you're tired of getting f***ed by Hamon users, you can eat a rokakaka fruit or find Jesus to become human again. Finally, there's sword style. While others are fighting with imaginary friends and superpowers, you have a sword. Very nice, dude. You might as well just get Anubis with the SAO skin and stay near the station listening to Crossing Field.
F***ing Starbuster stream.
To anyone who dares to come close to you. If you're poor and can't afford any of the fighting styles, you can just buy a bat for 150 bucks and bonk the shit out of everyone. The main goal of this game is to make as many Jojo references as possible. But other than that, you can beat the shit out of other people. Most stands engage in glorious melee combat, but if your stand has the pilot ability, you can fight like a bitch and be an annoyance. To win, just pick an overpowered broken stand and go haywire. Find some gay ass combo online, pray for the ping god, hope that your opponent doesn't have a stand that counters yours, and you can perfect block certain abilities and Uno reverse your opponents by stunning them. If you miss the timing, you'll be stunned instead, and if you don't block at all, you'll get shoved down like a disabled kid. When you get knocked down, your stand f***ing disappears like Josuke's dad. But unlike Josuke's dad, who Nigerandayo'd for like 17 years, you can immediately summon it back. You can do very menacing gay poses to regain HP, because Jojo poses transcend above laws and logic. To be honest, to become a true stand master, master of standing, you gotta be a f***ing nerd to learn everything about every stand in this game. Like the greatest stand user Sun Tzu once said, you gotta exploit other stands' weakness and abuse your stand's strength. Good stands like Gorodo Experience, Requiem can suck ass if you don't know jack s***. And stands like Zahando can literally slap people out of existence if you know what you're doing. And by that I mean knowing how to press T and Y. Actually, this stand is pretty brain dead. Actually, most stands are pretty brain dead. The story of this game is basically part 5 but very scuffed. The main character is not Giorno, but a random guy. That random guy being you and me and everybody else playing this game. After getting dragged in the shitstorm by these strange men dressed in very gay fashion, you become the mafia boss after killing the mafia boss, because that's how the mafia works. You know, the story makes absolutely no sense. Like, Giorno wants to sneak past the police officer with the suitcase he stole. So you went ahead and f***ing massacred all the police officers. Like, was that really necessary? Then right after you kill these 5 cops, he asks you to return the suitcase to the person he stole it from.
Then why did I kill those 5 cops for then? I got murder charged for nothing.
But again, no matter how scuffed this story is, because Diavolo died, this can be considered canon. After finishing the story, you'll be level 25, and from there on, you'll need to grind random quests to level up. It's recommended to go Viet Cong and stay in the sewer for the zombie kill quest until level 30, spawn kill Dio until level 35, and spawn kill Jotaro until your max level. If you're a filthy casual and can't defeat the bosses, you can always get some friends and gank the sh** out of the boss, because teamwork makes the dream work. To prevent friendly fire, you and your comrades can join a gang and become the superior, cooler rogue gangsters. Once you're max level, you can pay this guy with the protagonist hair to bite the dust though and raise your level cap by 5. You get more experience from quests when you prestige, so it's a little bit faster to grind. The max level is 50 at prestige 3, and if you're a sweat, it's possible to speedrun it under 3 hours. Every level gives you 2 skill points that you can use to upgrade your stand, stats, and abilities. You can only get a maximum of 100 points, meaning you don't have enough to max out all of your skill trees and become the ultimate life form. Other than the level grind, you'll need to roam around the street like a homeless person and search for stand arrows and fruits to get shits that you want. You also have to grind for pieces of Jesus and kills to evolve certain stands. But honestly, compared to the other Roblox RPG, grinding in this game is like f***ing taking a piss instead of taking a shit. That was a really bad comparison. There are currently 3 game modes. The main game is where you do quests, grind XP, run around scavenging for arrows to stab yourself with, eat roka fruits to kill yourself so you can stab yourself with arrows again, murder random people, drink tea, and fight Joe for the 40th time. Colosseum is where you fight people without being able to pull the ultimate secret Joe Star technique. Nigga f- You can either engage in glorious and honorable 1v1 or have a good 2v2 fight with your Joe bro. It is custom and good manner to yell
Shiza!
On top of your lungs when your Joe bro dies. My mom just told me to shut the fuck up. You could aim for the top 50 leaderboard, but honestly, most people are just here for Zavalodo over heaven. Because the reward you get from winning is shit. It's literally 50 bucks. It's not enough to even cover medical fees. Finally, Metal Ball Run is a cheap Chinese knockoff of Part 7 Steel Ball Run, a racing Fortnite battle royale. There are 2 modes, casual and competitive. Casual is for poor kids who don't have OP stance, because OP stance are banned. For some reason, people are less aggressive in casual and usually won't start fights until the end. Real men play competitive like chance and will start beating the shit out of each other the moment the race starts. The race is divided in 6 stages. Black, wait, that's not it. Yeah, I'm too lazy to explain this shit. It's basically a horse race where people can beat each other up with stands, except the end of the 5th stage, where only 7 people can survive. Here, people can either go full on Fortnite battle royale, have a 1v1 tournament arc, or find some random guys that act sus and gank the shit out of him, which is what happens most of the time. This is the great filter where only the popular cool kids can survive. If you have Joe bros, you will have a better chance to survive, because people wouldn't dare to f*** with you when your Joe bros got your back. Once you have made into the cool kids club, congrats, now you have to race through the New York Bridge. Be warned though, this is America. People's got guns. They will not hesitate to shoot you to knock you off your horse. In casual mode, here is where most of the saddest anime betrayals happen, because only one person gets to get a piece of Jesus. Some fake Joe bros will not hesitate to shoot you in the back. In competitive mode, however, the top 3 all gets a piece of Jesus. So it's recommended to only get 2 Joe bros, because any more than that you have to deal with Zeus imposter Amogus. The top 3 in competitive mode also get cosmetics, cold hard cash, and horse feet to buy better horses. Now that you have overpowered stance and max level, all you can do is walk around menacingly and bully people. Most of the game passes are for endgame players, so if you're filthy rich and have extra Bobux to burn, you know, feel free to purchase. You can buy stance slots so you can add more stance to your fine collection, or switch stand and fighting style to counter someone and beat his ass. You can also collect cosmetics by playing Steel Ball Run and cosplay as your favorite JoJo character, such as
Speedwagon.
Even after the millionth game, the Devil's Palm will still give you PTSD with the obnoxious ReZero sound effect that goes like that damages both your character and your mental health. You can also test your luck in arcade, only to realize that, yeah, you're getting scammed pretty hard there. If you're an intellectual, you can collect Stando Guro Furandos, such as Zavardo, but with a vagina, D4C, but with a vagina, King Crimson, but with a vagina, and Megumin, but with FBI.
I'm going to jail!
These skins, unlike other f***ing garbage, have the special ability of attracting simps that will give you free sh**. Or freeze people in battle because they're either too busy admiring the thickness of these creatures or too busy bleaching their eyes out. You know, I never really understood why Roblox porn exists, but now I might. This enlightened me. My PP is very confused. Oh god. Oh no. No. Considering how rare the lucky arrows are, obtaining these are almost impossible because the chance of you obtaining the skin stacks on top of the chance of you obtaining the stand. The pity is bullshit and doesn't help at all, and it reset every time you rejoin the game. So let's have some fun and calculate the odd of you getting Zavarudo but with coochies. So 1.5% times 1% times 50%, that's a pretty low number, man. You actually probably have more chance of getting a real life girlfriend at this point. What did you say? You're gonna pay rolls with Bulbucks? Well, times 2 then. That's still kinda low, man. Only the chosen ones and people of focus and sheer f***ing will can get them. They are a symbol of power and wealth, and they cannot be obtained by common peasants. So if they're so hard to get, how did I get them? Well, I sold my f***ing soul to Satan. That's how I got them. Man, listen, if you're really that desperate for a Roblox stand waifu, you need to seek medical attention now. Hello? 911? Yes, I need medical attention. And that is about it. Now I have a trade offer. You offer subscription and comment, and I offer an explanation on how the f***ing King Crimson works.